Hello folks, today is February the 6th, 2024. It's a Tuesday, about 11 o'clock. And I have taken my hair apart because I had it tied with rope to the drawbar. And then I had this section tied with rope. And I began to see where it was failing. The hooks would separate. And so... Actually, there's four pieces. There's one, two, three, four, and the two pieces are held together with these little U-bolts, and they have come off. So I went to the hardware store. I got one missing here, and two missing over here. So I went to the hardware store and I bought this replacement. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to tighten them up real tight, and then I'm going to take my welder and I'm going to weld the end of the bolt so it doesn't back out. And then I'm going to do some more welding on these pieces to keep them together. And I'll show you that in a minute. The other thing that happened is that this is what I hook on the back of my Polaris to, and I put it all over the hitch on my Polaris and pull it. Well, the chain broke. So it's a real small chain. So also at the hardware store, I bought a bigger chain and that will not break. And so I'm going to weld the end of that bolt so it doesn't back out. I'm going to cut these pieces off here and put that ring on there before I weld it. And that way it will be able, I can go back and hook it back onto the back of my Polaris or my truck, whatever it is I'm going to pull it with. So that's what I'm fixing to do right now. So I'm going to put the camera off, back on the stand, and then I'm going to put these three on these pieces right here, and then I'm going to weld them together, and then we'll go to part B of a three-part project. Okie doke. Okay, I'm going to cut this chain off of this ring. Keep the chain for another project. Okay. So now I'm going to move over here and put those U-bolts on. Connecting all these pieces together. Let's do that one first. That was going to take two. Okay, Houston, we have a problem. This is a little bit wider than what can go inside that eye of that hair where it joins together. So I'm going to put this in the vise and grind it down, these two, all three of them, I guess. And okay, what I thought I would do is show you, I've grinded two up and down and got them onto the hair, but I thought I'd take one and show you how I'm doing this. This is galvanized, and you can't weld galvanized. You have to take the galvanized off the piece of metal in order for the weld to take. So I'm buffing one side where I'm going to weld, and then I'm cutting down one side so it would fit through the eye of the Okay. Let me see if this fit. Okay, so that would fit pretty good. So I'm going to take this grinder and grind off the old ones so I can put a tack weld on it off the end of the bolts. Okay, I've got those grounded off, and I'm going to move my welder over so I can start welding those. I may just actually pull those around so I can get to them. Okay, I got three to weld. One, two, three over here. And then I'll switch the camera around and on those three over there. So let me get my welder up, hooked up. Okay, intermission, something. My wire feed's gone bad. Well, all right, well, I'm back at it again. My welder ran out of wire. And that's the first time I've ever changed the wire since I've owned it. And I've owned it for 15 years. And it's the first time I've run out of wire on it. Of course, I've used it, the welder, more since I moved over here than I was when I lived in West Tennessee. So, we're right back at it again. Alright, so I got the couplers connected. Oh, I forgot to do that one over there. Got to do that one real quick. Okay, all right, so now I'm ready to take that bar and put it on the front side, which is the side that's up against the walkway. I gotta get it turned, bring that over, and then I'm gonna take some rebar and tack it to the hooks so that we'll hang on and I don't have to tie it with the rope anymore. So let me get that set up and then we'll come back. Okay, so I've got the hook through the eye. I took my grinder and buffed off the ends. And what I'm gonna try to do is weld a piece right in there like that to keep it from coming out of the eye. I'll do that for every one of those. And before, when I was putting it together when I bought it, I realized that was going to come off all the time. So I had put a rope through this eye and a rope through this eye and tied it. And it was holding up pretty good until, you know, the rope obviously stretched, and then the eyes, the hook started coming out of the eyes. And so I said, well, I got to fix that. So this is what I'm going to attempt to do. I'm going to try to weld that piece right there pretty good so it won't come out of the eye, and we'll see how that goes. So I'm going to put the camera back on the stand and see how I can get this done. All right. Thank you. not grounding to the metal, so I'm going to have to do some more scraping on the metal to get it to take the ground. So I'll get back with you. Well, I finally got through with it. This second half over here, I put the hooks together and I welded a half inch rebarb on each hook so they wouldn't come apart. At least I fused some metal. And then I did the same thing with the hooks that's on the bar. So I think I've got it back together where it may stay together for a little bit longer. We'll see. Now I got to get it on my trailer, which is a job. So anyway, I thought I'd give you an update on that, and I'm going to take it over to the property and get to where it's back operational. Okay, well, I'm going to put my stuff up and call it a day. And thank you for watching. Talk to you later. Bye.